Chapter 8, and how he came to be called Maniac. The town was buzzing. The schools were buzzing. Hallways, lunchrooms, streets, playgrounds, West End, East End, buzzing about the new kid in town, the stranger kid, scraggly, carrying a book, flat-soled sneakers. The kid who intercepted Brian Denny's pass to hands down and punted it back longer than Denny himself had ever threw it. The kid who rescued Arnold Jones from Finsterwald's backyard. The kid who tattooed giant John McNabb's fastball for half a dozen home runs, then circled the sacks on a bunted frog. Nobody knows who said it first, but somebody must have. Kid's got to be a maniac. And somebody else must have said, yeah, regular maniac. And someone else said, yeah. And that was it. Nobody, except for Amanda Beale, had any other name for him. So pretty soon, when they wanted to talk about him, the new kid, that's what they called him, Maniac. The legend had a name, but not an address, at least not an official one with numbers. What he did have was the deer shed at Elmwood Park Zoo, which is where he slept his first few nights in town. What the deer ate, especially the carrots, apples, and day-old hamburger buns, he ate. He started reading Amanda Beale's book his second day in town and finished it that afternoon. Ordinarily, he would have returned it immediately, but he was so fascinated by the story of the Children's Crusade that he kept it and read it the next day, and the next. When he wasn't reading, he was wandering. When most people wander, they walk. Maniac McGee ran around town, around the nearby townships, always carrying that book, keeping it in perfect condition. This is what he was doing when his life, as it often seemed to do so, took an unexpected turn.